Continuing with our top focus here in closely tracking developments coming in regarding the severe cyclonic storm that is being caused by Cyclone Nisarga, which has already made its landfall just about an hour ago. This was close to Alibag, which is about 100 kilometers from Mumbai. As we speak, this is a landfall process which is to continue for a total of 3 hours, and heavy spins, heavy speed winds, and the cyclonic storm is moving further up into areas of Mumbai and Thane. The speed of the wind that has been recorded at the time of the landfall was 120 to 140 kilometers per hour. It has now slightly been pulled down to 100 to 110 kilometers per hour. But we have been tracking developments here ever since the past couple of days in a massive evacuation process that has already taken place by the NDRF in the affected areas. And now we're looking at how the cyclonic storm is impacting conditions. Witnessed already. This is in parts of Mumbai, Thane and Palghar, which is in Maharashtra. Parts of Gujarat have been impacted here, south of Gujarat, in this cyclonic storm as we speak. As the landfall process continues for 3 hours, of the storm, though, is to continue for another few more hours in a total of 6 hours. We have with us our correspondent, Alicia, who has been getting us details in how the changes have been witnessed now in Mumbai. Adisha, what more can you get us? This is with respect to development now that in this minute as the storm approaches Mumbai and Thane.
Well, Sahir, you're in the city of Mumbai. We have been witnessing very heavy wind speed, the intensity of the wind speed. And we are here reporting from the Nariman Point area, which is in the South Mumbai. And like you can see, the impact is already visible on the ground level. We have seen 3 big trees being uprooted here, which has caused damage to the footpath as well. This is one of the huge tree. Of course, the second tree that we can see that has half fallen on the middle tower, completely blocking the first 3 floors, as you can see. So that is the impact of the intensity of wind that we are showing you on the ground level. And if we just walk down further, me and my video journalist Nitin Fartare, we are showing you this right from next right next to Vidhan Bhavan quarters. You can see 2 big trees have been uprooted there. There's the BMC disaster management team that is present there to clear the entire situation. You can see it's the BMC team. There's the crane also that has just come in to uplift the entire tree, because the tree, of course, is very big. And this is the intensity of the wind here we are talking about, Seher. And let's not forget that the impact, the cyclonic storm has still not hit Mumbai. So this is the pre-cyclone, of course, the wind intensity that we are looking at, uprooting of trees, and this is not one such area. We have seen several instances of tree uprooting from Colaba as well, which is in South Mumbai, from Bandra as well, which is in the suburbs of Mumbai, and also from the other areas like Andheri. So all of these are the ground situation, and this is what the BMC has said, that in case of any such incidents really take place of the tree uprooting, there are about 50 plus teams, disaster of course, that will be deployed across the city to check and to clear the area within hours, so that people do not really face this sort of inconvenience. We are not really going very close to where the activities happening, because there are a lot of trees that you can see, and the wind intensity also is gradually going up and coming down. So in less than 2 hours, this is the situation on the ground level that we are looking at here in the city of Mumbai.
All right, so these are certain tree uprooting incidents that have already been reported here. Disha, of course, the NDRF along with the local municipality has been saying these are going to be now focus areas where roads would be cleared up, in which pathways have been disrupted because of the heavy speed of the wind. when is that to start? Because we are now looking at the intensity of the wind also reducing. The latest that we got was now about 93 kilometers per hour. Is that good enough, safe enough for the NDRF now to be on ground in starting these relief operations as well?
Well, Seher, we could not really gather your question very clearly because of the intensity of the wind and the wind speed. But just to answer what we could gather, of course, as far as the relief process and the evacuation process is concerned on the ground level, BMC has finally started evacuation today. And as you can see, the wind intensity speed has already increased here in the city of Mumbai. Specifically here in the area that we are looking at, what visuals that we are showing to you at this point in time, the wind, how it is moving in that direction, that is what we are showing you. And this is the concern that the agencies have, that the cyclonic impact could have here in the city. So for this, more than 8,000 people have already been evacuated from the low-lying coastal areas, from the landslide-prone areas, Seher, 235 shelter homes that BMC has arranged. Uh-huh. Apart from this, there are three NDRF teams that are deployed, that are on standby as we speak. And for any sort of emergency situation, if there is any relief work that needs to be done, that will be taken care of by the NDRF team, is what we understand. BMC's advisory is very clear and simple, uh-huh, to not really venture out. If you can, you know, look at on that, the intensity of the wind and how it is moving, it's really getting very difficult, you know, in such situation. But on the ground level, these are the situations managed by the BMC's disaster response team at the moment, Seher.
All right. Well, Disha, stay on with us if we can keep that audio connect, or else we'll reconnect with you in just a bit. We're also going across to our correspondent, Santhia, who is at Alibag. She's been tracking those details ever since the cyclone made its landfall. Santhia, has the weather any close to being settled or being less intense as we speak? Because the storm is further moving up to Mumbai and Thane.
See, as of now, here on ground in Alibag city, Seher, rainfall is still heavy. Heavy rainfall is still going on. Intensity of the wind is also there. So as of now, at least we don't see the weather settling down. It might happen in some time, but as of now, you can clearly see that the wind intensity is still strong. You can see that the rainfall is still heavy. This is Alibag city for you. You can see branches of trees are uprooted, and it's not just the branches, Seher. In fact, in Alibag city, trees are also uprooted in some parts. Apart from that, as far as the intensity of the weather is concerned, it is not looking like that it's going to settle. As of now, you can see that how the you can see the movement of the trees, you can see the intensity of the rainfall as well, and electricity connection, of course, power connection is snapped in the area. Communication lines are interrupted. Phone networks are also hugely impacted in this specific region. Now, the place where we are right now, we are actually on Alibag. We are actually at Alibag Beach. Apart from some journalists and some teams of government officials who are there to keep a watch on the cyclone situation, no one else is out there in the city. No one is allowed to step outside. Those were the advisories. Those were the warnings which were issued by the district administration. And it's not just Alibag, Seher. In fact, the other regions of Maharashtra also, Palghar, Mumbai, Thane, Nandurbar, Nashik, Dhule, and of course Raigad district, in which Alibag is, all those places were also under red alert, which means that extremely heavy rainfall was predicted by IMD in the isolated parts of those regions. This is Arabian Sea for you. The visibility, of course, is extremely poor right now, so I don't know how much I can give you the feel of the sea visually, of course. But as far as the sea is concerned, this is the coastal line, Seher. And talking about this coastal line and the Alibag area and the nearby villages, there are around 62 villages where a population of 1.71 lakh people live. And those who were living in kaccha makans, according to the district administration, were evacuated and they were shifted in the shelter houses which were identified by the local administration. Talking about Raigad district, total 25,000 people were evacuated.
Right. Santhia, do we
five
have initial...
Five teams of NDRF are in Raigad, and out of these five, three are actually in Alibag.
Yes, Santhia, do we have initial details of damages that have been reported so far?
Seher, unfortunately, because of the communication issues and connectivity issues, we are also not really connected with what's happening in the other region of other parts of this region. As far as the city is concerned, now we can't even move into the city as of now till the weather settles, because the tree uprooting is happening, branches are being uprooted. It's not safe to venture in the city right now. That's why we are at this corner, because it's low tide right now. So this particular part of the beach is a location which is marked comparatively safe by the authorities. That's why we are media teams have been asked to stay put here. So what's exactly happening in this region is something which the details of which we are yet to get, but what we can see from here, because this is that place which is said to be slightly safe. Here also branches have been uprooted. In fact, the barricading which was there to mark the safety zone, those barricades are also blown up by the strong winds here. So clearly situation is bad inside the city. So trees uprooting, that has happened in Alibag city, but the routes which connect Alibag to other places, what is happening on those routes, that's something we'll be able to understand once this particular weather settles to some extent,
right,
at least. But there are instances of roofs of houses being blown up by strong winds in this region and other parts of Raigad because of the intensity of the storm. And this is and why not Seher, because this is something which is kind of historic, because this part of the state specifically, despite many cyclone warnings, a cyclone of this intensity has never made a landfall this close to Mumbai, because we are talking about Alibag, barely 100 kilometers from Alibag. In fact, as I said, branches uprooting is still going on. It's happening. That's why what kind of damage is there in the nearby areas, that's something we'll get to know only once the weather settles in. In the meantime, I can show you what kind of what is this cyclone doing to Alibag city, the weather. You can see when you look at these trees, when you look at them in the visuals which we are showing, you can understand what's happening here on the ground. Now these are coconut trees, and we have to understand that coconut trees are also dangerous. They are extremely dangerous and more vulnerable and weak actually in such situations. They are tall trees they're tall, and of course coconuts are also falling, and that can be fatal. And the trunk is extremely thin also as compared to any other tree. That's why coconut trees are dangerous, and this being a coastal area, there are many coconut trees. In fact, the trees which you can see in front of the camera are coconut trees, and you can see how they are struggling to stand their ground against this extremely strong wind. That is Alibag city for you. And not just Alibag city, nearby areas are equally impacted. Now I'll try and give you a comparison. When we came here, and if I can ask my camera person Sahil Suresh to pan the camera a little bit, and I would once again want to show you the Arabian Sea. So specifically this part of the sea, there actually is a fort there that's called Kolaba Fort, and when we came here some hours ago, that fort was visible, clearly visible, but that's not the condition anymore. Now you'll not see anything, you'll just see a white sheet sort of a thing on the screen, because that's how bad the visibility is in this area, Seher, because of the cyclone. As I said, the only good thing about this whole situation is that it's not high tide. That's why the flooding which is happening in the city, at least the seawater is not contributing to it at all. The flooding which is happening right now in the nearby areas is happening only because of heavy rainfall which is there, which continues to be there along with the strong winds. Now, what it looks like is more than the rainfall.
And Santhia, as you were explaining. Yes, and as you were explaining that the relief here, of course, is that this is not high tide, because of which flooding is not being reported. It is only heavy rainfall. But stay with us, please, because we're getting in breaking inputs. This is in keeping track of latest details now that are coming in from the IMD and in the absolute latest reporting from the Indian Met Department here. The IMD now saying landfall process is to be completed in 1 hour. So a total of 3 hours, having spent 2 hours already, we are left with the 1 hour remainder of the landfall process. The cyclonic storm is to weaken in the coming 6 hours. So it is going to be stormy weather, but the intensity of this is, of course, going to further weaken. This is as per prediction of what happens post the landfall, the intensity of wind speed further reduces. So this is going to be reducing in the coming 6 hours. Also, adding to that, the IMD says a cyclone likely to move in northeast direction. So that's the latest path of the prediction of this storm. The wind speed has now much down to 93 kilometers per hour. This was reported at 1:30 p.m. in Alibag. So this is far less intense. Remember, at the time of the landfall, it was between 120 to 140 kilometers per hour. It was much stronger. Now it has reduced, and this is specifically speaking at the point of the landfall there in Alibag, which has been further reduced now to 93 kilometers per hour. Let's also get in the latest word that we got in from Mr. Husalkar, who is the Deputy DG of IMD, explaining the landfall process here. Let's in fact take a listen to that as well.
जो आई बना है निसर्ग का, वो रायगढ़ के पास है, और उसका जो नॉर्थ ईस्ट पोर्शन है वो रायगढ़ को आप जो है वो टच होके जा रहा है। तो अगर आप यहाँ पे सैटेलाइट पिक्चर में देखोगे तो ये जो साइक्लोन का आई है वो यहाँ पे हमें दिख रहा है, और ये लैंडफॉल की प्रोसेस जो है अब शुरू हुई है, और ये नॉर्थ नॉर्थ ईस्टर्ली जाएगा, और ये रायगढ़ में से ऊपर पास होते हुए मुंबई के कुछ इलाका और थाना के कुछ इलाके को पार करते हुए आगे चला जाएगा। उसके बाद इसके साथ ही ये जो टोटल प्रोसेस है जिसको हम लैंडफॉल कहते हैं, ये तकरीबन आने वाले 3 घंटे में कंप्लीट होने की संभावना है। तो अभी साइक्लोन का जो आय है उसके जो क्लाउड वॉल है वो रायगढ़ के पास अलीबाग के पास वहाँ पे उसको टच हो रहा है। हाई विंड्स वहाँ पर रिपोर्ट हुए हैं, मोर देन 125 KMPH विंड अभी हमें मैसेजेस आए कि वहाँ पर भी कुछ हाई विंड्स रिकॉर्ड हुए हैं, और ये आई जो है ये मूव होके ऊपर की तरफ जाएगा, एंड इट विल क्रॉस रायगढ़ देन पार्ट्स ऑफ मुंबई एंड थाने एंड इट विल गो अप। दिस प्रोसेस विल टेक अनदर 3 hours.
Yes, that's the explanation of the route of the cyclonic storm, which is what the three-hour process of the landfall is. We also got in a word here from the DG of the NDRF in this exclusive interaction here. Listen in to Mr. S.N. Pradhan. This is with respect to preparedness in both affected areas of Maharashtra and Gujarat.
The landfall is almost approximately at the same place as predicted by the IMD, which is slightly south of Alibag in the Raigad district of Maharashtra, and all the teams are on standby. About 43 teams of NDRF are deployed in the two states, out of which 21 are in Maharashtra, 16 are in Gujarat. As per reports that we got from the state authorities, about 40,000 or in excess of 40,000 have been evacuated in Maharashtra, in excess of 40,000 again in Gujarat. So, and if you count the evacuations in the Daman and Diu and Silvassa area, so we are talking about an evacuation nearly 1 lakh of population that has been evacuated from the cyclone's path.
Let's also get you specific details. This is preparedness in the city of Mumbai and what the BMC has done so far. Remember, Mumbai becomes all the more challenging because this is a city with one of the highest number of COVID positive cases, 40,000 plus as we speak, also with a very, very high number of containment zones as well. A lot of the low-lying areas that would be impacted by this storm are also containment zones. So that has made this process all the more challenging of evacuation and providing shelter homes with social distancing norms, and also patients that have been relocated as well. The BMC, with this evacuation process across the city, in about 10,000 people that have been moved about. 35 civic body schools that have now been converted in providing the temporary shelters here to the people. Generators that have been provided in low-lying areas, because of course there is going to be power outage. Communication snapping of lines is going to take place here as well. 16 teams of tree cutters are on standby, and we're giving this information as we have already reported a couple of tree felling incidents in the area of Mumbai itself. Take a listen in to the BMC commissioner on this.
Sunday raat se aur Monday morning se pure joron se taiyari shuru kar di thi iski. Sabse pehle humne hamare jitne ward officers hain, assistant commissioners aur deputy zonal commissioners hain, jo hamare field arms hain BMC ke, उनको हमने बोला कि SOP दी हमने कि आपको क्या क्या करना है. नंबर वन हमको हमने बोला कि जो लो लाइंग एरियाज़ में हैं, कोस्टल एरियाज़ में है, स्पेशली स्लम एरियाज़ हैं, वहाँ से लोगों को शिफ्ट करना बहुत ज़रूरी है. कि हमारा पहला उद्देश्य ये है, जीरो लॉस ऑफ ह्यूमन लाइफ. आई हैव टोल्ड एडिशनल कमिश्नर संजीव जायसवाल दैट वी ऑलरेडी हैव 5-7 lakh फूड पैकेट्स विद अस एवरी डे. Some migrants have gone out, so still we now these days we need about 5 lakh packets. We have surplus 2 lakh packets. So this food should be diverted to these quarantines where people will be coming. We have already shifted as per the records with the data available with me about half an hour back. More than 10,000 people we have shifted through our efforts, and another 30,000 people have gone off their own, because since yesterday we have been making a lot of announcements इन दीज एरियाज दैट आपको खतरा है. आप खुद यहाँ से कुछ देर के लिए, जब तक साइक्लोन चला नहीं जाएगा, आप शिफ्ट हो जाइए हायर एरियाज के लिए, हायर एल्टीट्यूड पे या दूसरी जगह पे जहाँ पे आपको खतरा ना हो. मैंने सारे MAH को मुझे जो मेडिकल ऑफिसर्स हैं उनको बोला है कि शाम को, कल को जब भी साइक्लोन के बाद में वापस जाएंगे, उससे पहले इनकी हेल्थ की तपासनी करनी, आरोग्य तपासनी, जैसे हम स्लम्स में करते हैं. आज एक दिन आप जनरली स्लम्स मत जाइए, आज सारा अपना फोकस करिए इन लोगों पे, तो इनको स्क्रीन करके इनकी हेल्थ को, फिर इनको वहाँ से रिलीज करिएगा. तो हमारे दो काम हो जाएंगे, इनको हम स्क्रीनिंग भी कर लेंगे, उसमें अगर कोई कोमॉर्बिडिटी हुई या दूसरा कोई तकलीफ हुई उनको हम हॉस्पिटल में डाल देंगे, तो ये भी काम साथ में हो जाएगा.
All right, detailed word there coming in from the BMC commissioner. We are going to be looking at Mumbai and Thane now being impacted as the storm is further moving ahead. Stay on with us, please. We're getting you minute-to-minute updates of the movement of Cyclone Nisarga.